Up next, please allow me to introduce an amazing speaker, Mr. Faraj Abutalipov, the Chief Commercial Officer of the Venom Foundation. He's an experienced executive with 15 years of corporate, startup, and VC experience. He's a Harvard Business School alumni and is a Dubai resident, here to shed insight on the Web3 transformation from Wild West to institutional regime. Please welcome him with a large resounding round of applause.
Hello, everyone. Glad to have all of you here. I think for the next short 5 minutes, I'll try to explain you why crypto is on the verge of going from the Wild West and into the institutional regime. So basically, everyone around is talking about crypto. We're all here in the crypto conference, but the institutions are here to come and conquer this market and change it in the ways that internet was changed since the 1990s. Lots of friends of mine, like André Cronier and some others, they believe that the technology and the state as we are having now is very similar to very early internet stages. And currently, what we can see is that institutions are coming, like the likes of BlackRock, Fidelity, and others. So what exactly they're coming for? So one of them is private equity and tokenization. So private equity before that was only available for the very rich people. So you cannot buy like one flat out of huge building of the commercial real estate, for example. You usually buy the entire building. And the same goes for the selling it. So you cannot sell one or few meters of your apartment. So tokenization will allow for that. So it allows for the increased liquidity. It also allows for the reduced costs of the transactions. So some of the transactions in the trade finance are huge, and this lets the people to transact way, way cheaper. Obviously, there is also fractional ownership, so lots of people can own the same asset, and greater transparency because blockchain is immutable. So another thing that might change the finance industry big time, it's CBDCs and stablecoins. Stablecoins are government-backed, fiat-based stablecoins. That's what we're talking about here. And this might come into some in the nearest future. So as a Venom, for example, we're in talks with multiple governments. With some of them, we are signing MOUs for introducing the stablecoins, fiat-based stablecoins in those countries. And there is a demand from the country to actually leapfrog the financial lack of financial banking industry in their countries, to solve the remittances issues, to solve the inter-country trades, and it all can be solved with the blockchain, with the DeFi components of the blockchain as well. So the trade finance, it's very important topic, and the bringing blockchain there can solve the $1 to $2 trillion that currently is as a gap exists in the trade finance, where small to medium enterprises do not get the necessary funding for their businesses and for their trades. It's very complex, it's currently very inefficient, and blockchain can bring huge number of benefits to that industry, streamlining the processes, getting the wild measures in terms of the like openness, like greater transparency, immutable of the operations, getting everything cheaper. So the trade finance is the next big thing. So disruption of the supply chain, that's and putting the supply chain on a blockchain, that could be a next big thing for the crypto industry to go into and disrupt that. And this will drive the mass adoption as well, because every step of the supply chain can be actually influenced by the crypto. One of them could be for example, the smart contracts that can be introduced between buyer and seller, and et cetera, et cetera. Carbon credits, UAE is very progressive. They've signed with Venom Foundation the creation of carbon registry. This is really, really important step for the entire country. and we're there to make UAE greener and bring the carbon credits to everyone. So in general, we are in the middle of the transformation area where decentralization, AI, and sustainability can come together, and this will be a fuel for the entire transformations of the economic change. So I'm really, really looking forward to the next bright future where the institutionals will come into the Web3 and actually will drive the positive change towards the entire economy, similar to how internet changed the entire world. Thanks a lot, guys. Thank you very much.